Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to change the color of your SVG file for Cricut or Silhouette. And to do this, we're going to go to Vectr.com, which is an online vector editing software. So SVG files are Vectr, so it makes sense to change them in software that's Vectr, so then you can save them as an SVG and go from there. All right, let's get started. So here are the steps we're going to go over in this video. First, we're going to upload our image. Then we are going to change the color and then export. And in that screen, we can also resize our Vectr to any size without losing quality. So first, let's head to Vectr.com. That's V-E-C-T-R.com. Then I'm going to choose Use Online. On the left side, you'll see Open File, and that's what you want to choose. And then you'll navigate to the design you want to change the color of. And this design should be an SVG file that you downloaded from Etsy or something like that. Then choose Open. So now we can see our file on the screen. Click the file to select it. And then on the right, you'll see a bar that says color right here. To the left of that is this dark little circle. That's the current color that your SVG is. So I'm going to click this. And now up here is our color bar. So if I just click here, I've changed the color to that color. We can also use this slider to move through the different hues on the color range, but I want this to be white. So I'm gonna click on this little circle and just drag it up here. And I'm gonna drag it a little further off the edge of the corner. And that'll give me a true white. We can see down here it says FFFFFF, and that is true white. If you have something different here, you can actually just type in hashtag and then 6Fs, and that will give you true white. So it looks like our design has disappeared, but don't worry, it's actually still here. Transparency just doesn't show up in this program. It shows as white. So we've got white on white, and we can't really see it right now, but that's okay. Now above color on the right, you'll see this little arrow, and this is the export arrow. So I'm gonna click that, and now we can see the transparency and the white. And here we can also change the size of our design. If I click pixels and change this to inches, I can see that our design is 7.7 inches by 6.4. This little lock will make sure that nothing is stretched. If it's unlocked, you will stretch it. So make sure your lock is locked. So I'm going to change my height to 8.5, and that'll make my width 10.2. I'm going to keep it as an SVG file because that's best for Cricut. That way we can get in Cricut and resize it to any size. And then I'll download. Now when I download, at least in Chrome, it'll show a white screen like this. But if I go out to my downloads folder, I can see it's downloaded here as page one. And now if I open Cricut Design Space, I can come over here to Upload, then Upload Image, Browse, and navigate to my downloads for page one. And I'll open this. And here we can see the image, and it's a cut image. So I'll upload. I'll click on it, and then I'll add to Canvas. And now this is really huge. I'm gonna resize this. I'm just gonna make it 12 by 10. Okay, and now I can go back into 100%. So now I have my nice white design, and I can just go from there. I can make it or print it for Print-A-Cut, but you do have to have a printer that uses white ink, and you would need to print on like a transparent film. Normally you wouldn't, but since this is white, most printers can't print white. Now this would work well in Cricut, but if you're going to cut it, you actually don't really need to change the color because it'll cut the same way no matter what the color is if you're looking at vinyl or something like that. But you can also download as a PNG file. And if we download this, you can see it's kept the transparency and all that. So this is a really great tool to just change colors easily. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.